How do you guys feel about going to space? Almost everyone wants to experience the thrill of space and seeing the dark sea of space. What if you could go on your computer, book a ticket, and then go to space? Well, that's exactly the plan of Virgin Galactic in the coming years. Virgin Galactic is planning to make commercialized spaceflight accessible to an average person. This might sound as a sci-fi fantasy, but it's actually going to be possible in the coming decade. Over the past decade, Virgin Galactic has already been working on innovative aircraft and spacecraft to get us there, and they have completed multiple successful test flights to space. So what is Virgin Galactic's future plan to go and take everyone to space? Well, we're going to tell you all about it in this video. Please like the video so we can keep making quality content like this for you. Virgin Galactic's Richard Branson plans to win the space race. Virgin Galactic was founded back in 2004 by two strong figures in aviation history, Bert Rutan and Richard Branson. Bert Rutan is a brilliant aircraft designer, often known for building light, efficient, and sometimes strange-looking aircrafts. He designed the Rutan Voyager in the 80s, which became the first plane to circumnavigate the globe without stopping or refueling. On the other hand, Richard Branson is no rookie either. He founded the Virgin Group back in the 70s, which today encompasses over 400 companies in various different fields, including the very famous Virgin Atlantic Airline. In 2004, with Rutan's knowledge of aircraft and Richard's experience of business, the duo teamed up and formed Virgin Galactic. The core idea and vision behind the company is that one day, an average consumer can just hop onto a spacecraft, fly into space, and then return back to Earth. It would be something like going for rides at an amusement park with a very hefty price tag. In its initial days, the cost of going to space will be $250,000 per person, but over a period of time, the company plans to decrease the price and make it more affordable. The company says its eventual goal is to establish Earth-orbiting hotels and science labs, and eventually full space exploration. But let's get back to Earth for a little bit and talk about the present scenario of plans and missions by Virgin Galactic. The first question for any company in space exploration is, how are they actually going to accomplish it? Which launch vehicle or space shuttle will they use? Right now, the company has barely passed the first step of making some flying machines for getting humans to space. To accomplish it, Virgin Galactic has designed a two-craft system. It consists of a mothership called White Knight 2 that carries the actual spacecraft called Spaceship 2 up to an altitude of about 50,000 feet to give it a little boost. Spaceship 2 then separates from the mothership and completes the journey to the edge of the atmosphere. Then the gravity pulls the spaceship back to Earth and it re-enters the atmosphere and lands on its base. The White Knight 2 is a four-engine dual-fuselage jet aircraft that flew initially back in 2010. It has a pretty impressive turnaround time and is able to complete four flights daily, but the part that will actually get you into space is Spaceship 2. Spaceship 2 is a reusable winged spacecraft that can carry 8 people, including 2 pilots. One of the groundbreaking aspects of the Spaceship 2 is its feathered re-entry system, where it can rotate its wing backwards and actually create a shuttlecock effect on re-entry, and hence enabling the aircraft to achieve more aerodynamic drag to slow down while lowering the thermal load. In comparison to other aircrafts like the space shuttle, which need to rely on heat shields on re-entry, the aircraft is also allegedly so safe that it can enter the atmosphere at any angle. After the re-entry, the spacecraft acts as a glider and lands back to Earth on its own. The previous prototypes, White Knight 1 and Spaceship 1, were much smaller versions, and they served as the prototype for building the later models like Spaceship 2. But what about the experience as a private astronaut on Spaceship 2, which is the main goal of Virgin Galactic? Well, for that you have to wait in line after the 8,500 people who've already signed up for a flight, and not only that, it's going to cost you $250,000 per ticket. The company says 600 people have already purchased tickets, including celebrities like Justin Bieber and Leonardo DiCaprio. When the logistics and paperwork are all taken care of, you'll be ready to enroll in a 3-day training course at the Virgin Galactic Spaceport in New Mexico, where you'll receive guidance from senior astronauts about the systems on board and how to be an astronaut. Also, you'll get medical and fitness programs that you will have to follow. After this 3-day training, you'll be finally ready to fly. You'll be strapped into Spaceship 2, which will be attached to White Knight 2, and soon you'll be reaching an altitude of 50,000 feet. Minutes later, you'll be released from the mothership, and rocket engines in the spaceship will fire, entering the spacecraft into a vertical climb, soon reaching a top speed of Mach 3.5. And during this acceleration, you will experience around 3.5 Gs. After just 70 seconds from the initial ejection, the engines would be shut off, and the spacecraft would be shut off, and the spacecraft continues to climb, using its remaining momentum at this point. Very close to peel altitude, you start to experience weightlessness in microgravity for around 6 minutes. This happens just above the Kármán line, 100 kilometers above sea level. Eventually, after some time, the gravity starts to pull the spacecraft back to Earth, and the crew has to change the wing configuration for re-entry. After re-entry, the wings are put back to the normal position so that the plane can be a glider to land back at the spaceport. This entire process takes about 2.5 hours. In 2020, there have already been multiple successful space flights of the Spaceship 2, and this year in 2021, Virgin Galactic has announced that 4 mission specialists, including Branson, will be on board to evaluate the company's astronaut experience in a space test flight. The 6-passenger, 2-pilot VSS Unity, one of Virgin's Galactic Spaceship 2 vehicles, flies brief missions to suborbital space. This will be the 22nd flight test for VSS Unity, hence the mission's name, as well as the company's 4th crewed spaceflight, and the first ever to carry a full crew of 2 pilots and 4 mission specialists, which include Branson, the company announced in the same statement. This amazing announcement has got everybody on their heels. Richard Branson is likely to beat Jeff Bezos, the founder of Blue Origin, in the race to space, who earlier announced his plans to go into space along with his brother on July 20th, 2021. I truly believe that space belongs to all of us. After more than 16 years of research, engineering, and testing, Virgin Galactic stands at the vanguard of a new commercial space industry, which is sent to open space to humankind and change the world for good, Branson said about the flight in the announcement statement. It's one thing to have a dream of making space more accessible to all. It's another for an incredible team to collectively turn that dream into reality. As part of a remarkable crew of mission specialists, I'm honored to help validate the journey of our future astronauts that we'll undertake and ensure we deliver the unique customer experience people expect from Virgin, he added. But you might be wondering, why did it take so much time to send a fully crewed mission? Well, spaceflight isn't as easy as it seems. Also, a major roadblock in Virgin Galactic's schedule was the tragic accident in October of 2014, when during a test flight, Spaceship 2 broke apart in mid-air. Unfortunately, the co-pilot was killed and the pilot was seriously injured. The NTSB then conducted an investigation and cited inadequate design safeguards, poor pilot training, and lack of rigorous FAA oversight as the cause of the crash. The crash exposed a much broader failure in the design. The company then announced to improve upon its mistakes and not rely as much on the pilots. Aside from commercial space tourism, Virgin Galactic also announced the development of a new orbital launch vehicle for small payloads. This rocket, named Launcher 1, aims to take packages of around 200 kilograms into orbit. And recently, in January 2021, Virgin Orbit became the 3rd privately funded American rocket company to reach orbit, and the only one to a spin-off of Virgin Galactic accomplish the feat from mid-air. This was only their 2nd demonstration flight, and it carried around 10 small CubeSats into orbit. The successful launch was a welcome win for the Virgin team, which has been buffeted by setbacks since its first attempt failed. It was aborted seconds after the launch due to a breakage in the propellant line, because of which liquid oxygen wasn't able to reach the engines. After these 2 successful attempts and an upcoming full crewed test flight, which is most probably going to be another huge success for the Virgin Group, a question that arises for Richard Branson is, will he be able to convert this into a sustainable business? Since Virgin Orbit's rocket is launched from a plane, it has an advantage in the customer market. It can take off from any airport in the world that will allow it, and it can tailor the launch location to the customer's orbital needs. A lot of people have already registered for their suborbital flights, so it seems like a booming business opportunity for the Virgin Group. Now, Virgin Orbit has joined the special club of orbital launch vehicles. But in the cutthroat world of launch services, it will ultimately be the market that decides whether the company gets to keep its membership. Virgin Orbit's Launcher 1 platform is unique because it is the first air-launched orbital rocket that is liquid-fueled. With this successful launch, it's slowly stepping into the arena of the likes of SpaceX, Blue Origin, and United Launch Alliance. Though Launcher 1 was originally designed to be deployed from White Knight 2 as well, but as the payloads grew heavier and heavier, the duo would no longer be able to reach its original altitude, so instead, a Boeing 747 was used for the launch role. So guys, there you have it, Virgin Galactic in a nutshell. Virgin Galactic has got big plans for the future of space. From making space travel a possibility to taking payloads into space, Virgin Galactic has a big future ahead of itself. What do you think about flying into space? What would it feel like? How is it going to transform the meaning of space and traveling? What do you think about Virgin Galactic's mission to make space travel accessible to everyone? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as it encourages us to keep making amazing videos for you. Thanks.